This is Krakow, Poland. Steeped in centuries of history, the city is a literal living museum. It's so historic that the entire city center is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. Full of beautiful churches, bustling markets, and horse and buggy rides. But as picturesque as it is, most residents don't live in the city center. They live here, in massive concrete tower blocks built far out in the suburbs.
Like many cities in the Eastern Bloc,
Krakow relied on these dense suburban enclaves for growth, connecting them to the city with a massive web of tram lines. But with the collapse of the Soviet Union in 1991, the city was left in financial ruin. Faced with increasing traffic congestion, Krakow needed a cheap way to move more suburbanites into the city. Their solution? Speed up the trams. Like many cities, committing to an expensive metro project is no easy task.
And for decades, Krakow's residents relied on its roads and a dense network of inner-city trams for transportation.
But following the Soviet Union's influence on Poland,
the city emerged as a bustling industrial hub. To protect the historic city center, Krakow's growth was directed outward, resulting in countless high-density developments built far outside its city limits. The largest of these was Nowa Huta, a centrally planned industrial enclave set to house more than 200,000 people. Krakow desperately needed a new form of transport to serve its fast-growing suburbs.
And in the late 1960s, Krakow planned to build a metro between Nowa Huta and the city center. In 1974, work began on the 180-meter section of the tunnel running under the main Krakow railway station.
The metro was set to revolutionize mobility in the region, bringing suburbanites closer than ever to the city.
In the 1990s, due to economic downturn, the metro concept was abandoned, but a short section of the tunnel was already built. The solution was to repurpose the metro tunnel for trams. The city center was a bottleneck. Many trams converging on the Central Ring Road and having to mix with other traffic. Even with dedicated lanes, it is still slow as it had to negotiate tight curves. The city center of Krakow is relatively compact, so you don't need much to relieve congestion for the trams. This tunnel allowed trams to go underground in the most congested parts of the city. Polytechnica station is one of two stations in the short tunnel, and that's all you really need to get the trams out of the city center congestion. This massive roundabout used to be a flat junction where trams, cyclists, and pedestrians all had to interact with other traffic. Now it's grade separated with an entrance to the newly built tunnel. Instead of tunneling the entire tram line, grade separations are only done at junctions where most of the conflicts occur. This offers most of the benefits at very low cost. The idea is to get trams as fast as possible from this tunnel into this dedicated median right-of-way. This is a major hub for many different tram lines coming together and going different ways. Therefore, this separation is important for the reliability of the entire tram network. This depressed tram junction also offers for a great environment for pedestrians and cyclists to get across this huge roundabout, which is four or five lanes across. These four-segment trams offer plenty of capacity for the crush load, especially what you see in rush hour. These are 48 meters in length and are the longest trams in service in Poland. Signal priority works very well on this line. There's very few places where we've had to stop for red lights. The tram here is switching from a median right-of-way back to the side-running alignment. This type of switching reduces land acquisition costs, allowing the line to be built for less.
This tunnel exists to avoid a mountain in the way of the fast tram network, and it cuts travel times. Strategic placement of grade separation like this one enables the tram to run headways of 5 to 10 minutes. This is really cool, a massive bridge built for trams and cyclists. This was specifically built to facilitate the transfer between the trains on the lower deck and the trams above. I've learned 3 key lessons during my time here in Krakow. First, strategic grade separation can drastically improve tram service when implemented on only a few select and targeted locations. Second, absolute signal priority can provide metro-like service and reliability without requiring full grade separation. Third, we can mix dedicated right-of-ways for trams. The fast tram consists of side and median running tracks, bridges and tunnels connected by seamless transitions.
Would Krakow be better off with a metro system? Probably. But given the dire economic circumstances of the time, Krakow created a feasible alternative, a cheap, scrappy evolution of a century-old tram system to meet modern demands. Although it's just a blip in Krakow's century-old history, the fast tram is a testament to the city's resilience and ingenuity as it continues to stand the test of time.
Myself up, moving on to the back.